This video is brought to you by Storyblocks. Hey guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to a brand new episode of Copycat Friday. Now in this weekly series, we recreate visual effects from famous films and music videos. This week, a lot of new music videos came out, and interesting enough, we found three videos that all have sky replacements. And these were Baila 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 from Ozuna, Undecided from Chris Brown, and Jumpin' on a Jet from Future. And like the name of the effect says, we're going to replace the current sky in our shot with a different one. And there are actually five different techniques to do that. All of them have a different purpose and were all inspired by the music videos mentioned before. Let's start off with the most easy one of all. Simply film your subject and make sure that there's plenty of sky visible. To make it yourself easy, film all of this from a tripod. If you want to make it yourself hard, then you can go handheld. In Adobe Premiere Pro, put that shot into your timeline, and now we are going to make that sky a bit more interesting. So go ahead and jump onto the interwebs and search for pictures of anything that you want to get up there. For example, the moon or other planets. If you are creating something for the public or commercial work, then make sure that you have the proper license to use any of those images. Then import your photos into Premiere Pro and drag them on top of your timeline. With it selected, head over to the opacity property and then click on the pen tool to draw a mask around the planet. Finally, change the blending mode of the planet to screen and perhaps decrease the opacity to make them blend even better. Scale and move the planet into the sky where you want it to be, and that's it. Now you can also add more elements to the sky and of course design something that looks unique. Now since we were on a static tripod, you could also add one of our free handheld camera presets to it. I'll leave a download link in the description below. Now, if you did move your camera, we're going to have to jump into After Effects and track the motion. Now it is best to track a tree in the background or anything else that is far away in the distance. You can then connect the planets to the tracking data and have it move with your camera movements. You can find a tutorial on how tracking works inside After Effects as well in the description below. So that was the first sky replacement where you add elements to the sky to make it more interesting. The next technique is something that we didn't see in the music videos, but it just looks cool, so we just had to add it to the list as well. For this one, you'll definitely need to film from a tripod. Make sure that it's during the day and that there aren't too many details in the horizon. We have a straight building, which is gonna make it easier. Then stop recording, but keep your camera on that tripod. Wait until the night falls and then make that same shot again. In Premiere Pro, these two shots lay on top of each other. With the top one selected, head over to the opacity property, take the mask tool, and draw around the horizon, which is the building in this case. You now have a daylight shot with an evening sky. You can also swap it, of course, and maybe edit that to the beat of your next music video. Sky replacement number three. If you can find yourself a blue sky, then you are lucky, because this is the sky replacement that could give you the best results. In Premiere Pro, I'm going to search for the Ultra key and drag that to the clip. With the color picker from the effects, I select the blue sky to remove it. Use the settings below to further tweak your keying. If you change the output to Alpha channel, you can see the mask. Everything white is what you're going to see, and the black will be removed. Now just go ahead and place your desired sky beneath the clip. And this is something that I got from Storyblocks, which is an online library packed with high quality 4K stock clips. Now Storyblocks is our sponsor, but we're also a heavy user ourselves. Almost with every project, there's something that we can use from Storyblocks, such as an effect, transitions, etc. You can download unlimited video assets for a single price per year, which makes their library so interesting. To check it out yourself, you can visit the first link in the description below. Now, as an extra touch, you could use Lumetri to color grade your shot to make it match better with the sky. For example, make it darker, add some contrast, and change the white balance to blue to make it seem more like a night scene. If your sky is not so blue, in other words, the weather is bad, you can also just film against a cloudy sky. Now pay attention in your shots that you have a clear difference between the white or gray sky and everything else in your shot. In Adobe Premiere Pro, we're going to start off by searching for the curves effect and drag that to the clip. You can also use the curves from Lumetri if you like, both are the same. The top right of the curves represent the highlights. So by adding a point a little down on that line and pushing the upper part to the left, we're going to make their gray sky even whiter. The more contrast that you can get, the easier the sky replacement will go. Next up, search for the Luma key effect and drag that to the clip as well. Lower the threshold until your subject or the horizon is not keyed out anymore. And then you can increase the cutoff to remove the sky. Now you're probably gonna be left with a white border around yourself, and it's just very hard to get rid of that with a Luma key. But we can fix that. Apply the Ultra Key effect to the clip as well. We're not going to use the keying option in here, but we are going to scroll down and look for the matte cleanup properties. From here, we can choke the Luma keying or feather the edge. And finally, place your favorite background clip underneath that clip again, and this one also came from Storyblocks. The next sky replacement is gonna be a green screen, which you can do inside or outside. That doesn't matter. What is important though is that your green screen is going to be lit evenly. You don't wanna see any wrinkles and you don't wanna see any shadow. So that's why this portable green screen is ideal, because it's tightened within this frame and that way it's always wrinkle free. Now, the idea is to key yourself completely out and put yourself into a different background. Now, what is important though, is that your lighting is going to be somehow the same as the background. Now, we are going to work with the northern lights, which we unfortunately didn't see when I traveled to Iceland. So that's why we're going to fake it today. The northern lights is something bright in the sky. So that's why I'm going to step forward and become a silhouette. An angelic right here is going to shine this green tinted light onto my face, which is the reflection of the northern lights. Like before, filmed from a tripod. Now, Jennings is shining green light onto Lorenzo's face. But because the luminous level between the light on my face and the green screen in the back is so different, it's actually not going to be a problem. In Premiere Pro, when using the Ultra key, you don't only select the green color in your shot, but also the luminance and saturation level of that green selection. Silhouettes is also something easy to key, because you have this big contrast between the subject and the green screen. Very important is that you know upfront what your background is going to be. See where the light comes from in that background and recreate it in front of your green screen. So after you've pulled the key, go back into your opacity property, take the pen tool and mask away anything else from the scene. You might want to add a Gaussian blur effect to the subject to make it appear a little bit out of focus because it sits closer to the lens. And that was it again. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Yeah. Doop, 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 doop. Yeah. Doop, 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 doop. Yeah. Doop, 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 doop,
doop, doop, doop, doop, doop. It's okay, Artie. Let's get back to the studio.
All right, let's get back.